Varanasi turned into a flashpoint between the Election Commission and the BJP after the party's prime ministerial candidate Narendra Modi was refused permission for three events, citing security reasons. The seething BJP said this amounts to a ban on Mr. Modi in his own constituency, which goes to vote on the 12th of May. Led by Arun Jaitley and Amit Shah, the BJP will demonstrate outside the district magistrate's office. In a final affront, the BJP has also withdrawn all requests for the rally. Narendra Modi will now land at the university's helipad and then travel by road to the party's headquarters, where he will meet with workers. The Election Commission offered the BJP an alternate site to hold their event, an offer the BJP turned down flat, saying it was too late and that the permission for the main rally was still missing.
In the world's most ancient and sacred city, Narendra Modi's political pilgrimage stopped. His Banaras pitch, two public meetings and a much-publicized Ganga Aarti hit a roadblock with a virtual ban imposed on his city campaign. Varanasi's local administration denied permission for one of his rallies in the city. The Ganga Pujan and a meeting with prominent citizens also met the same fate. The official reason, vague and seeped in contradictions, triggering a massive political controversy.
छोटा कटिंग के आसपास बड़ी चौड़ी सड़कें हैं, वहाँ कंजेस्टेड एरिया है और छोटी छोटी सड़कें हैं पास में, और वहाँ पर अगर ज्यादा भीड़ हो जाती है तो फिर समस्या हो सकती है, इसीलिए हम हमारी खुद की रिपोर्ट से ये जनरेट करते हैं कि अनुमति देनी है अथवा नहीं। पुलिस की रिपोर्ट है हमारे पास, हमारी इंटेलिजेंस यूनिट है, उनकी भी रिपोर्ट है, जिसकी वजह से हमने ली।
A furious BJP cried foul, threatening protests led by senior leader Arun Jaitley. Their allegation, Varanasi's returning officer was effectively stopping Modi from entering city limits, while the same rules were not applied to his opponent Arvind Kejriwal.
This is not a banana republic that a prime ministerial candidate by a pliant returning officer is not allowed to address a meeting in his own constituency.
But as the controversy grew, pressure increased on the administration, and amid allegations of political mischief came this suggestion.
They have applied, we have allowed.
They themselves applied for cutting memorial. But they're saying it's a smaller venue, something like that.
They have applied, we have allowed. No problems.
What about the remaining programs?
Remaining everything has been allowed.
All of it has been allowed?
Haan.
Including the Ganga
Aarti? We have thoda sa schedule change kara rahe hain.
Okay.
Otherwise, usme koi problem nahi.
In a final affront, the BJP withdrew its applications for the three events planned in the city. Senior leaders say Modi's public meeting will happen from the party headquarters, and this version of their rally will be even bigger.
Do you see this as a healthy development? Was there no other alternative for the BJP but to sit on dharna against the Election Commission, a constitutional body?
You see, I'm extremely saddened by the turn of events. You have all the constitutional power when it comes to dealing with the political parties and individuals, and you suddenly collapse in terms of your authority when it comes to dealing with a delinquent returning officer. Any conscientious authority would have removed this man forthwith by now.
But the BJP has rejected this compromise formula, saying the alternative venue can accommodate only 2,000 people. The party had strategically chosen Benia Bagh because the historic ground is in the heart of the city and a prominent Muslim area. Less than a week ago, the rally on May 8th was meant to be one last push in the prestige battle, with Modi's high-voltage campaign ending with another roadshow on Saturday. Bureau Report, NDTV.